to do this, and thanks for this movie. I hope you guys enjoyed it. So I want to ask you about the background behind this. It's your first feature film. So I was interested, of course, about the background, how you came up with this format, this walk and talk film. To hear about how you about your work partnership,
right? Emily and I worked on two films where Emily was a producer, and we already had a great relationship, and you know, a great working relationship, which is so important when, as an actor, you need to trust your director. And I asked her at the premiere of The Kitchen, this film we did, what are you working on? She's like, well, I got this script. And you know, it's about an expat and an Asian American who meet in Hong Kong. And I'm like, oh, that sounds cool. Did you know that I'm dating Jamie Chung? She's like, I did not. She's like, well, you guys should read the script. So we read the script out loud, and there were so many similarities to our own life and just how timing works. And we loved the dialogue. We fell in love with the story, and we called her over in.
What kind of preparations did you have for the movie? I really like the portrayals of both characters. You're playing this character. Did you hang out with the local Australian bankers? Is there anything specific that you did? You also speak a bit of Cantonese in it.
Yeah, I hope I didn't botch that too. The person who taught me Cantonese was Scottish, so I think my Cantonese is Scottish. Yeah, I think the hardest part for us was, because we already had an off-screen chemistry, was to unknow each other. And so Jamie had the brilliant idea of getting two hotel rooms, which I didn't really agree with. What are you gonna do?
What about you, Jamie? How did you connect with the character? How did you build this character of the movie? Like, I imagine this is bad. Any conversations with
you? Yeah, there's so many similarities. You know, so easy. Like the first time being in Hong Kong, and it was, you know, it was just the discovery. So when I'm looking around, like that really was like the first time I was looking around. For real. I mean, we did rehearsals and whatnot, but to literally plan out physically how long one scene would take, like how many streets. But I was trying not to enjoy myself better, so I really wanted it to be, you know, wonderful person.
Was it difficult to play with your real life fiance and distanciate yourself from her?
Is that your question? No, it's great. Like, I mean, we work on each other's scenes all the time at home for other projects. And I think, personally, I was really excited to work with Jamie because she doesn't get to play these kind of roles, which are these romantic movies. You know, she's always doing these action movies, which is the movies that I never get to do. So. But I was really just so happy that she had a chance to play this great role, and I thought it was decent.
Certainly, like after a 12-hour shooting day, you're like, all right, bye. Let's go to our separate rooms, and that helped.
What about shooting in Hong Kong? So I think Hong Kong is has its good size and bad size in terms of shooting.
Yeah, I mean, like making your first film is already challenging, and then to make your film in a foreign country like has a whole different set of challenges. So we have permits to shoot all over Hong Kong, but we didn't have a budget, obviously, to walk on the streets. So everything, like all the extras that you guys saw on the screen, they're just beautiful of Hong Kong. Like we basically just showed up and threw my two actors into the busiest streets of Hong Kong and said, okay, go and do your scene. And like for a lot of them, we would like hide, like the camera crew would hide across the streets using our lens, and they were locked, we couldn't put the room out. So a lot of times people would just like pass them by and not even realize they were doing the scene. But that's exactly what I wanted. It's like I wanted to capture these two people in this really realistic, busy metropolis. Because if, you know, if you've been to Hong Kong, it's like Times Square times 100. Like that's how crazy it is. But on certain other sequences where, you know, we have a lot of these walk, like really long walk-and-talk sequences, they're all done by city cam, and it's, you know, 4 or 5 uninterrupted minutes. You know, like we do these really long takes, and everything we go through is like in the first, like, third or fourth minute, like the performances are great, and like the camera work is great, and then out of nowhere, you'll have a drunk voice crowd that, you know, like comes behind and is like, hey, mom, or like say hi to the camera, or tell us to get off your street, or yell at us, and then we gotta like start all over and do it again.
Yeah.
So I'm afraid to say the drunken expats.
Yeah, it was only the expats. The locals were cool. The drunken expats were the best.
Yeah, they were the biggest challenge. And then the weather also was, it was just, Bryan, if you could tell me how hot it was.
Hot. Yeah. This is not the kind of film where we had dressing rooms or anything like that, so we literally had a van that would wait, it was on, and the air conditioning would be running, and we'd shoot the scene, we'd run into the van, pull off, go around the block, and then come back. That's kind of how we stayed with the wet armpits.
Nice. Was that the first time you were shooting Hong Kong as well? That was the first time for you, Jamie?
Yeah,
never
again.
And it was only my
first
time too. I would ask all of you before turning to the audience about, I would ask you about the Linklater influence, of course. Were you familiar with Before Trilogy? Is that something that you watched, or did you try not to watch it if you had not to be influenced?
I hadn't watched them until we signed on to do this, and she said, you should probably watch this.
I did not watch it. Because I didn't. I know, but I felt like I wanted to separate the originals with this one because it was much more personal to me personally. Reading the scripts, I had so much to relate to it, but Yeah, so I come in here.
Well, I think they're very similar, you know, in genre, but I feel like this movie is a little more grounded, whereas those movies, they talk about this esoteric philosophy, these conversations, they, I don't know, what I responded to this movie was the dialogue and how real it was. I think that's what sets this film apart.
Yeah, like, I keep getting this question.
Now I'm going to turn to the audience, if you could raise your hand and ask see the lady over there. All the way back.
Yes.
Yes, the lady over there, yes.
We're going to Hong Kong next year, so
I think it's fun. There's most of the expats are on the Hong Kong side, but I think there's a really cool scene in the Kowloon side, and that's mostly locals, and it's under the tunnel. So when that thing that he did when you're trying to grab a taxi that's going on the other side, like, that's a real thing. It's like, are you going?
Watching this movie hopefully gives you some idea of what to do. So basically everything we show in this movie is like the best places to go. The Hong Kong tourism board should be paying this.
I want people to go to the gym now. I think nobody knows about it.
That it's called Ping Pong 129 and it's the coolest gym bar.
Yes.
It is, because you went there. But when we shot at that bar, it's all been open for we were the first film to shoot at that bar, and then since then, the bar is like, oh yeah, like we're getting calls all the time, like people wanting to shoot at the bar.
Okay, this is a great bar, I'm gonna shoot a film as well.
Yeah.
Yes, the gentleman over there. How was the film coming?
Well, the film was all funded independently, so it's pretty much all self-financed.
Justin Bieber.
I saw a lot of Justin Bieber. It was like Jagger to Walmart.
Next question. Yes, the young lady. you speak a tiny bit louder, because I think.
I don't know, that really questions your character.
I think I left. I did not go upstairs. No, I did. Is he going to see this
movie? That's a great question.
I will tell you.
He's here!
No! And he has not seen the movie. And he keeps emailing my producer asking to see this movie, and he cannot show me this movie. Yes, I have seen him again, and we've actually become friends. But I will tell you this. I think the movie is a lot more romantic than actual.
Are they still together?
No, they're not still together.
Hmm.
I'm a different person now, so.
Okay, I need to know.
Hi, thank you, that was beautiful. Oh, thank you. Say one capital shot, and did you post music?
Okay, we actually shot on the Canon C500. We shot on two cameras. And we actually got the camera from Film Independent. So they gave us the entire camera package for free. So Canon Film Independent, which really helped us out. And we didn't even have to settle for the camera just because they gave it to us for free. We actually did a camera test in Hong Kong where that was the camera we wanted to use because it was very lightweight and because it was, you know, running away. And we did all of the post-production.
Yes, all the way to that track.
That was the connection. And she's like, you need to meet Richard. You know, he's a brilliant comedic actor, and he's, you know, my friend's dad. Like, just meet with him. And I met with Richard, and literally we spent 3 hours talking about his character. And, like, he was on set for less than that amount of time. But he's just such a dedicated actor. Like, he, like, brought on all these, like, backstory of the fortune teller. And he came really, really prepared. And then once we were on set, I would say like half of that scene was improvised by Richard and the actors, and they just really went along with the ride.
Can we talk about, before we close the session, can we talk about your next project? Is there something already happening before actually I asked you to reveal your next book? Can you already talk about your next project?
This is, in the last month, we've got like 4 films come out, so this is one that is the most personal to me, and I'm very happy with this one. But yeah, last month I was a part in a high school film called Bessie, and I was playing music, but on an album, and now I'm in I'm development on a couple of projects.
What
about
you, Jamie?
Same.
Okay. Right. I really love Eden. I wanted to show you.
Yeah, so I have a couple scripts in development that I'm attached to write, and there's one that I've, you know, once I'm done with this, probably ready to kind of go out to casting and financing, but with
hope to see more of your films and all of you. So thank you guys.
Thank you guys for coming out to join us.